Hello dear students and welcome back in our biology session. So as we know, we have discussing our lesson, that is fiber from fabric. So in today's session we will see the next point from the same lesson, that is we will discuss about from fiber to fabric. Okay, so fabric means what? The clothes, whatever we are wearing, that is nothing but the fabric. But you are everything, how we are getting this fabric from the fiber? So to make the fiber into fabric or to convert the fiber into fabric, there are the certain processes, okay, and which are that processes that today we are going to see. So the first process in the fiber to fabric is what? Ginning. So what is meant by ginning? Ginning is the process of separating cotton fiber from their seeds, okay. So this ginning is nothing but it is the one type of the process in that cotton fibers are getting separated from their seed. So this ginning was traditionally done with the help of the steel comb, but nowadays the ginning process is also done with the help of the machine, and the name of the machine is what? Roller gin. Okay, so these days a machine called roller gin is used for ginning. So here in the image you can see the roller gin. After the ginning, there is a next process, that is nothing but what? Spinning. So what is mean by the spinning? So spinning, it is the process of changing fiber into yarn. Okay, so this spinning is nothing but it is the one type of the process in that what happens, all the fibers are getting collected togetherly and it get converted into the yarn. So this spinning is we are also performing regularly in our house. So our mother or our elder people are making the weave from the cotton that we are using in the earthen lamp or into the diya. Okay, so just now see Diwali over, in the Diwali we are lighting up the lamps. Okay, and to light up that lamps we are using the wick, that is we are in the Marathi we are calling as a vaat. Okay, so that wick we are making from the cotton, and that is nothing but which process we are performing, that is what? Spinning. Okay, so it is the process of changing fibers into the yarn. In that what happened? Spinning draws out the short fibers from the cotton wool and twists them together into a long continuous thread called yarn. Okay, so because of this spinning, what happens? The strength of the fiber is get increased. So for these also some hand operated devices are used. So the hand operated devices like hand spindle or the takli and the charkha are the two hand operated device used for spinning. Okay, so that hand spindle, it is also called as takli, and the charkha, these are the two hand operated device used for spinning. In rural areas, people still use charkha for making thread or yarn from cotton. So still now, or still today in the rural areas, people are still using the charkha for making the thread or yarn from cotton. Spinning of yarn on a large scale is done on the spinning machine. And if it is in a large quantity, then the spinning is done on with the help of the spinning machine. So in the image you can see this is the takli and this is the spinning machine. Okay, so to make a yarn from cotton, there is one activity, that activity you have to perform at your house, that is activity number one. And if I take the name word charkha, then you will remember the one great person, that was what? Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so let's discuss about something about him. Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, popularized the use of charkha. Okay, so because of the Gandhiji, the charkha was popularly known. He wore only khadi clothes woven from the yarn that he himself spun on a charkha. Okay, so as we know, the Gandhiji was wearing only the khadi clothes that was woven from yarn by himself. Next one. During the independence movement, he encouraged the people to wear a khadi clothes made up of homespun yarn and boycotted the imported clothes made in the textile mills of Britain. So during the independence movement, he encouraged the people to wear the khadi and to boycott, to do not use the imported clothes from the Britain mills. To popularize the use of khadi, the government of India constituted Khadi and the Village Industries Commission in 1956. To encourage the sale of the khadi, the government of India constituted the Khadi and the Village industries commissioned in 1956. So the next process in the fiber to fabric is that weaving. Okay, so what is mean by the weaving? It is the process to convert the yarn into clothes. So in the weaving, what happened? We are converting the yarn into the clothes. The process of arranging two sets of yarns together to make a fabric with the help of a hand loom or power loom is called weaving. Okay, so in the weaving, what happened? The process of arranging the two sets of yarn together, and from the two sets of the yarn, what we are doing? We are making a fabric with the help of the hand loom or the power loom here is called as what? Weaving. Wavers weaving on a small scale use hand loom. If the weaving is in a small scale, then the wavers are using the hand loom. Wavers means the person, those who are doing the work of weaving. And if the weaving is done on the large scale, then obviously they are using the electricity, the machine which runs on the electricity, which is called as what? Power loom. On a large scale, cotton fabrics are made by a big machines that runs on electricity. These machines are called power loom. So in the image you can see the hand loom. Okay, so this is the hand loom machine. Next one. So to understand weaving, let us do the following activity. So it is very important to make the weaving pattern from paper. Okay, so this activity you have to perform at your house, and like this weaving with the paper you have to make. We go through this activity, do this activity, and whatever you will make from this activity like this, you have to stick in your science notebook. Okay. Now we'll see the next method from the same point, that is knitting. Okay. Now what is my knitting? See here, it is the image how it is the knitting done. Next one. You must have seen a lady knitting a sweater or muffler with the help of the two knitting needles. See in the image how that lady is making the muffler or the sweater with the help of these two knitting needles. In knitting, a single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric. So in this knitting, what happened? A single yarn is needed, but in the weaving, what happened? We need the two yarns. Okay, but in the knitting, we need only the single yarn. That single yarn is enough to make a fabric. Knitting can be done by hands using knitting needles. See here, you can see the knitting can be done with the help of these knitting needles. Nowadays, most of the knitting is done with the help of the machine. Okay, and nowadays most of the knitting is done with the help of the machine. Okay, so this is what the fiber to fabric. While the fiber get converted into the fiber, these are the certain processes or through these the fiber have to go. From this activity 3, what is given? To obtain the fiber from fabric, things needed: cotton fabric, a magnifying glass. What we have to do? Take a piece of cotton fabric, look at it. Now with the help of a magnifying glass, observe the piece. Okay, like this magnifying glass we have to take, and we have to take one cotton fabric, and you have to see this cotton fabric properly. Next one. Now find a loose thread or a yarn at one edge and pull it out. If no loose yarn are visible, gently pull out yarn with a pin or a needle. Place the piece of yarn on the table. Now press one end of the yarn with your thumb. Scratch the other end of the yarn along its length with your nail. Okay. So if it is not possible to find out the loose thread, then you can pin out the thread from that fabric, and then you have to slowly scratch the other end of the yarn along with its length with your nails. Okay, and what you will observe after that, the cotton cloth looks like a continuous piece. When you observe the magnifying glass, you find that it is not a continuous piece. You observe that the yarn splits into a thin strands. These thin strands of the thread are called fibers. Okay, so the thin strands of a thread are called fibers. So here what we can say, that the fabric is made from the different fibers. It is made up of a number of threads interwoven with each other. And what is our conclusion? Cotton plant, then first process ginning, then cotton fiber, then spinning. Then spinning get converted into cotton yarn, and from that cotton yarn we have done the weaving. and finally we are making the cotton fabric. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have seen the fiber to fabric. Here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.